This video was originally taken for my TikTok account. However, I wanted to share it here with y'all as well to get your feedback, experiences, and to give you a sneak peek on the next blind community chat. So if you would like to participate, comment down below. Blind talk discussion. Props to Christy Kahn. She posted a video on this that I feel is very, very important and I'd like to expand on. She posted on her experiences with audio description at the movie theaters. I could totally relate. I have lived in 4 different states. I've lived in South Korea and I've been using audio description services at my theaters ever since it was first offered locally. I think this was probably almost 10 years ago now, y'all. I think location really doesn't have a whole lot to do with it. A lot of us can relate to this issue. I'm going to go in a lot more in-depth discussion on my YouTube channel here, maybe in a couple weeks. I'll do a blind community chat, hopefully, on this because I think it's very, very important to address this and try to promote some positive change here, y'all. But I have found in my experiences one of two scenarios will happen. First, when I explain that I'm blind and I request the audio description device, the employee will try to hand me a closed captioning device or hand me headphones and explain, here's the volume button to turn up as loud as you need, as if I'm hearing impaired after I just said I'm blind. Or the second thing will happen, which is most often, most common, I think, for many of us, is we'll receive the correct device, but it doesn't work when the movie starts and the whole fiasco of trying to figure out who do I talk to fix it, and the manager's involved and we're trying to find the right channel, trying to figure out what's wrong with the system, yada, 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 just to find out we're 30 minutes in the video and it's never gonna work. Years ago, movie theaters typically would not only refund our money, but give us 2 additional tickets as incentive to return back in hopes that they fix their system and we'll have a more positive experience when we return, right? This was an adequate solution for me. I think that's fair. Why would I return back after such a negative experience without that incentive? I mean, if you're gonna so proudly say you provide audio description services and you can't consistently stick to your word, why would I waste not only concession money, but money and on a babysitter all that time we've coordinated and figured things out? I mean, it's a huge inconvenience when these services that you claim you're providing don't work. The last year or two, I have not received that incentive to kind of resolve the situation. They'll refund our tickets, say sorry, see you next time. But yeah, no, guys, I'm sorry, you will not see me next time. I don't want to support businesses that don't want to try to adequately resolve the problem. They don't want to check their systems and their equipment, and they don't want to train their employees adequately to address services that they're supposed to be providing to individuals with disabilities. And I'm like, you know, if you really want to make it up to me, then put forth some effort there, y'all, and ensure me that you're going to fix it. Why would I go back to your establishment when I clearly feel like you don't see the importance of this and fixing it? I know COVID has probably hit movie theaters in a very devastating way and they probably can't hand out a lot of tickets, but you know, there's other things they can do. They could give us some concessions. They can, you know, give us promotions or coupons on something else. I don't know. Think creatively. That's their job. That is on them. The ball's in their court when they screw up. We're going to talk more about this on my YouTube channel, Seeing Blind, y'all. So hit the red heart button somewhere over here. If you can relate to this, comment down below what your experiences are. I'll talk to you soon, y'all. Bye.